Hello and welcome to another episode of Lemur's Corner. I am Lemur, and today we are going to talk about all the different ways you can play Ark and you can host a server and all that kind of stuff. I did a previous video where we talked about dedicated servers specifically on Xbox. However, I figured we kind of all cover each other, so I want to talk about all of them together. So let's just go ahead and click on the host/local join type thing, and we're just going to click go through these options down here. As you guys can see them, they're going to highlight on your screen right now. But basically, you have 3 to 4 different options. I call it 3 because procedural Ark is completely different, and we're not going to get into it for this, but I will go over it briefly. But you have single player, dedicated server, and non-dedicated servers, and then official. So to join official, you literally just go back to the main menu, you hit join, and you can find an official server. So these are my servers that I play on, but you can go ahead and click on here. Go to official servers. You can find unofficial servers on here also that people have created or anything like that. I do play on a PvE. I'll go ahead and link that down in the description down below if you guys want to play on that one. But let's go ahead and take a look at the different options that you do have for playing the game within your own computer, within your own settings. That's going to also include Xbox, PS4, so all of these settings are going to carry over to whatever you guys want them to be. So first things first, single player is always an option. You can play single player. You can do whatever you want on there. You're an admin. You can spawn stuff in. You can test stuff out. It's a great place to do that. Try to figure out new ways to do things. Practice a build. Decide how you want to build, where you want to build, and just really be able to zoom around the map. It makes things a lot easier. But to be clear, that is completely by yourself. You can't play with other people, so you're playing by yourself on single player. However, when it comes down to it, you have one save file per map. So every map you see up here has one save file. You guys can see it right here, right next to it. You have different options. You have dedicated server options, and you have single player data. Single player gets attached with non-dedicated, meaning it's run off of your computer, and then dedicated still is run off your computer, but it's got a separate save file. So let's go ahead and jump back to what I was talking about through the dedicated server data and all that kind of information. So the next option we have is non-dedicated sessions. That basically takes your single player and makes it a multiplayer map. You can lock that out to where your friends can only come. This works on PS4, Xbox, and PC, so you can do it on any of these options for running a non-dedicated setting. You can control it. You can choose who's admin. If you need to make your friend an admin, we can talk about that later of how to do that. But basically, you just have to host a dedicated server, have them join, make them an admin, and then switch back over to a non-dedicated. It gives them admin on the server. It's a very weird way that it works, but that's how you can do that on there. So basically, that's what non-dedicated is. The only catch is there's a tether. So if you're on PS4 and Xbox, it's a smaller tether. If you're on PC, you can extend that tether. Tether meaning you can only get away from a certain distance from the host. And if you're beyond that distance, it will warp you back to the host of the game. So there's actually a bubble that's around the host that you have to stay within. Now, as I said, on PC, though, you can expand that pretty much to the entire map. So you don't have to worry about that as much on PC. So that is definitely an option if you're on PC. If you're on Xbox or PS4, you really can't do anything with that on the non-dedicated for the tether. You can't really get it that large because you're very limited by the system of the Xbox or the PS4. So with that being said, if you're looking to get rid of that tether, you now have to look at actual dedicated servers. Those servers can be talking about creating them through Nintrondo. Basically, we're going to talk about the servers for Xbox, PS4 right here really quick. So those two specific systems, and then we'll talk about PC afterwards. But for Xbox and PS4, you have 3 options that you can do for Xbox and 2 for PS4. So the ones that they share are you can get a second system. So you can either get a second Xbox or a second PS4. You host off of that Xbox, and then you play off of the other Xbox that you mainly play on, or PS4. So, for example, you have to have 2 Xboxes sitting next to each other, one of which will literally just be running Ark as a dedicated server, and then you play on the other one that you normally would play on. You don't have to buy gold. You can do home share onto that one. As long as you own the second system itself, you can go ahead and host off of that, change your settings. However, you only could do the settings that there are within here. If you have questions on those settings, I'm linking a card right now where you guys can go ahead and check out the settings. I've done a tutorial on that also to break down all the settings and talk about what they do. But going back to it, that's option 1. Option 2 is you go ahead and talk to Nintrondo, and you can have Nintrondo host a server for you. You pay them, they host it, you can join off of it. You get a little bit more control over the different settings because you have access to a specific file called the INI files. These are where you can actually get in and change the coding and look in at things and change specific parts of the game where you can do auto engramming and things of that nature to focus on getting that stuff done. So that is an option on there too. Then on Xbox, there's actually a third option. And that option is actually you can host off of a PC. So if you have a computer that's sitting around and you're not really using it, but it can manage it, because you gotta remember, it doesn't need the graphics setting to do it. It just needs processing speed and RAM to really manage it and enough hard drive space to hold it. So basically what'll end up happening, and you have to have good internet, I should be clear, because your upload speed is what matters when you're hosting something, not your download speed. So I would highly recommend you check in on your upload settings and make sure you have a good upload to cover that. But what I was saying is you can have an PC, you can share the system from your Xbox. So I own Ark on Xbox and I own it on Steam. However, I could host off of the Microsoft Play Anywhere version on the Xbox off of my computer and then play on it from my Xbox. So that means everyone can play on it from their Xbox and you're hosting it off of your PC. That only works on Xbox because of the Microsoft interactions that they have there and allows you to go ahead and do those dedicated servers. So as I said, those are the three major options for Xbox, and then there's the two for PS4, and now let's talk about PC. PC is pretty much the same options. You can get a second server somehow. You can run into the computer. You can do something like that. Now, to be clear, though, PCs are a lot more demanding than the Xbox version of the game. I know it sounds kind of weird, but you need to have a high-end system that's got some serious CPU power and some serious RAM in order to host the server, because as I said, it's got a lot more power that's coming out of it because of these servers with all the mods. I mean, this is my PC and look at all those mods down there. If you put all those mods on there or something like that, it could be crazy and it could cause some huge problems. So backing up to it though, that is one option where you could buy a second one, host it, and then play on your first. That's definitely an option. The second option is there are hundreds of server options, places where you can pay Nintrondo or Ark servers or one of the million server setting or server places that you can go ahead and buy there. I highly recommend not using Nintrondo. I've had nothing but problems with Nintrondo, so I would suggest using anyone but them. But that's my own personal setting, my own personal feelings, my own personal experiences with that one. Some people have never had a problem with them. I've had nothing but problems with them deleting my games and that kind of stuff. But you can go rent a server from there. You can back up the files, all that kind of stuff yourself. It's just more of they allow you to use their hardware to run your game, and they give you a cool interface in order to do that. So those are the options that you have to play the game. As we said, we talked about ways to join unofficials and officials, but these are the ones to specifically talk about controlling your own settings, doing things the way you want them, and having things on there whether you want mods or not. And to be clear, right now, mods are only available on PC. They are not available on Xbox or PS4. But those are the ways. So you can play single player, you can do a non-dedicated, which is just basically taking your single player, making it multiplayer, and then you can run a dedicated server. We'll briefly touch on right now procedural Ark. That's pretty much you make up your own map and it creates it, and then you can do whatever you want on there. So that's one that you can create as a non-dedicated, dedicated, or even single player if you wanted to. But that's a procedural Ark, and it takes a long time to load, and I really have not had good experiences with it. Not a lot of people have, and not a lot of people use it. But if you wanted to ever make up your own map and kind of craft it in that way of like you can kind of craft how much percentages of this and this, that's the option for you. So those are all the options, guys. I hope this video clears some things up. As I said, I did one before. There were a lot of questions around it. I really wanted to cover it in depth. If you have questions, we are always here to answer them. Make sure you guys let us know down in the comments. Let us know what that question is. We'll try to get back to you very quickly and answer those questions. We'll do our best to respond to them to the best of our knowledge and give you the information that you need. But I hope you all we'll go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Make sure you guys hit that bell for notifications. Make sure you give it a thumbs up. Let us know that you like the video, you like these kind of tutorials. But as always, that's going to do it for this episode. I hope you all have a fantastic day, and we see you on the next episode of Lemur's Corner.